All glory, power, and honor goes to Abihawa and his son, the Mashiach Yahweh Shai. To all my brothers and sisters in this truth, laboring in truth, sincerity, special shalom to y'all. To the elders of Israel, teaching the Lord's statutes and commandments and how it's written, special shalom to y'all as well. To my brothers and highways and byways, salute. Now, it's your boy Zachariah coming at you. It's a real quick one. This one, Hidden Things, part 20. I'm going to take too much of your time. But what I really want to get into is, are we our brother's keepers? Because that is the second, but even the one of the most powerful commandments that we got to remember. Because when that commandment is enforced, everything falls into place, right? A kingdom is built. A nation is built on righteousness with that. So I'm going to go into a couple clips in this and precepts and tie it all in. And can only do, further ado, take a use, Fair Use Act. Hit y'all with that, 1976, and not my video, just for commentary purposes, all right? Now, this is the old New Jack City. If you remember, if you know, you know. And there's a part in this that it was heavy. When I looked at it, I'm like, this goes into what's going on and happened in Israel in the past, right? Future proves past. So minus the carnality of it, just focus on what's being said and the bonds and stuff. I'm gonna do some narrative and go from there.
Whatever happened to, am I my brother's keeper, huh? You know what happened to it. The world is mine. Remember that?
Now, I'm going to pause it for a sec because Nino Brown, which is Wesley Snipes, says something. Now, what he's saying is heavy in the spiritual sense. G Money responds to saying, listen, you remember what happened. Everything is mine, which means that pride, ego, right, got involved. Now, this is on a carnal level, but still it happens today in the truth. Now, when you understand the depths of this thing, you're going to see this happened even in the beginning of time, right? Now, watch this part here where I find was heavy as well.
I'm on the run, G. You can never go back the way it was. But I'll tell you how we can make it right.
Pulls a gun on. Hear what G Money says.
CMB. CMB. Man, we all we got. Am I my brother's keeper?
See how spiritual that is? He put the gun down. Like, he basically, if you watched the movie, you knew that he had to kill him for whatever reason on a carnal level. But he put the gun down for a reason. I'm gonna get into that with precepts because he's seeing something in that brother he knows that goes way back to the beginning.
Yes.
See that? Look at his face when he killed him. He knew, like, listen, what I did was off, and he felt it in his spirit. Now, I'm going to show you how deep that is going to the beginning of time. Stay tuned with some precepts. Right, as you can see from the clip, what he said, so I'm going to hit y'all with Genesis, and we're going to go to chapter 4. Now, the backdrop of that is Adam and Eve already sinned. They went to the idolatry. The Lord kind of took away the kingdom from them, so now they got to do certain things, right? So Genesis chapter 4, and it reads, and Adam knew Eve. Eve is Ava in Hebrew, which means from the man. Adam is the man, right? So Adam and knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. And she bared again and his brother Abel. And Abel was a keeper of sheep, which means he was a shepherd, but Cain was a tiller of the ground, a gardener. Now, who's buying up all the farmland right now, brothers? You're going to see how this ties in. Verse 3. And in process of time came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. Now, why didn't he bring meat? See? Now, we got people going around talking about vegan this, vegan that. and they don't eat meat, but they don't understand the concept of where these things come from. Nothing wrong with staying away from meat for a long period of time, brothers. I'm not talking about that. I'm saying it's the origin of where these ideologies come from, right? Verse 4, and Abel, he also brought out firstlings of the flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and his offering, but unto Cain and his offering, he had no respect. So when people see us bringing out, you know, Romans, was it 9 and 13, God hated Esau and loved Jacob. It was from the beginning. It tells you right here, he had respect to Abel, which means he loved Abel. He had no respect on Cain. It was from the beginning, God had favorites. God always has favorites anyway. Right? So we keep going. And hit y'all, we just skip through down here and we get to verse 8. And Cain talked with Abel, his brother, and it came to pass that when they were in the field, that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him. Now, if you understand right here, it's because Cain was rejected, right? And that brought about pride and ego. Same reason why G Money was ended up getting killed by Nino Brown. This is on a spiritual level of why Cain killed Abel. Dig it? And the Lord said unto Cain, where is Abel, thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? You just heard someone say that in the movie, but this is where they got it from, right? And the Lord punished Cain for that, right? Because that was wicked as hell. So even the Lord goes to say, and he says, where hast thou done? The voice of thy brother, blood carried out, Slocky, cried unto me from the ground, right? So, just skimming through for the sake of time, the Lord punishes Cain, puts a mark upon him, same mark that we got now, right? Because Cain is Esau when you understand this whole beginning and end. And Cain went out from the presence of the Lord and dwelled in the land of Nod, on the east of Eden. And Cain knew his wife, and she conceived and bare Enoch, and he built a city and called a name after the city, after the name of his son Enoch. For a lot of these Old Testament brothers that don't believe in the Mashiach Yahushua, the reason why you need Christ or Yahushua, however you want to say it, is because the Lord took men away from his presence. So you can't go to the Lord by yourself no more. Nobody can. That's the reason why the Mashiach was present. Adam and Eve, they were driven out, and he placed them at the east of the garden. So no one could have went to the Lord no more and walk and speak with the Lord one-on-one. Those is over. That's why you need the Mashiach Yahusha. He is the middleman, right? Not that you have to worship him, but you have to go through him, because the Lord ain't dealing with man like he was dealing with him from the beginning. He's not doing that. Was broken, right? Now I'm gonna hit y'all with what the Lord said, right? Both in old and new, right? Both in old and new. So let's get it. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor, and not suffer sin upon him. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudges against the children of thy people, but thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. I am Lord. Why this is being spoken? Because of Cain and Abel. Now, the Mashiach Yahusha comes back and he reiterates this. Mark chapter 12, right? This is read, which is Christ speaking. And thou shalt love thy Lord, thy God, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with thy strength. This shall be the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And there is none other commandment greater than these. Why? Because these were the first two from the beginning that was broken. Right? Eve got Adam to sin through idolatry, and Cain killed Abel and destroyed the brotherhood. And that's what all the prophets, including Yahusha, came to do. It was to restore the brotherhood back onto the earth. And without brotherhood, you cannot build a nation. You cannot build a kingdom, right? And when you realize how the Lord told us to move, I'm going to hit y'all in. So I'm going to go to Matthew 10 here. I'm going to start at verse 5, right? These 12, right? Jesus, a.k.a. Yahweh Shai, sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles and into any city of the Samaritans, enter ye not. So basically, you had to go to Judah first, then the northern kingdom, when you understand that. Now, what I want to get to is verse 11, right? And into whatsoever city or town ye shall enter, inquire who in it is worthy, and there abide till ye go thence. And when ye come into an house, salute it. Yahweh Shem Yahshua Brakadam. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it be not worthy, let your peace return unto you. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your words, when ye depart out of it, that house or city shall dust your feet. Right? This is the main thing. A lot of people are not worthy to hear this truth because they haven't been called. They haven't been updated into the understanding of this truth, or the Spirit of the Lord is not on them to understand. So we're not supposed to force nobody, push this down nobody's throat. We're just supposed to say, thus say the Lord. Whether you hear or forbear, brother, it's not on me, because you have to be worthy to hear this. The Lord had to chose you from the beginning to even hear this message. Or else it just sound like rain falling on a duck's back. It'll just roll off, right? So we got to understand that thing. This is the message. We loving our brothers as we love ourselves, but they got to be worthy to hear this. If not, scripture says, which is the Lord speaking, this is in red, this is a commandment, shake the dust off your feet. Because then the Lord goes in to say, verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than in that city. Lord is saying, listen, what you think happened in Sodom and Gomorrah is going to be 10 times worse. So who don't want to hear and who ain't worried to hear, when they see this judgment come, they're going to see the true meaning of what the Lord mean by judgment. They're going to understand Isaiah, Ezekiel, everybody they're going to understand on that day, because the Lord is going to microwave this planet. And it's going to be in righteousness. Now, I'm going to take y'all back for a sec, because I wanted to hit y'all with something that was heavy in Genesis, right? Because a lot of these people, they come from the religion of old, right? Babylonians and all this other stuff. So what we got to understand is when they do their religion, we got to understand the origin of it. Now, I want you to pay attention to this part right here. And in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought out the fruit of the ground, an offering unto the Lord. And Abel brought out the firstling, okay? So who's buying up all the farmland now? There's a particular people buying up the farmland. And we got Abel here that's bringing out meat, fruit and meat. Somebody doesn't want you to eat meat right now. Right? And there's no such thing as, oh, meat's bad for you, because Abraham lived 300 years eating meat. Job lived damn near 120 years. So they all ate meat. So that's not what it is. Okay? Right? So understand, there's nothing wrong with not eating meat for a particular time and cleansing your body. But once you make it into religion, it's going into a whole different thing. Now, so this book basically was from back in the days. And my brother had it, gave it to me in 1983. I knew a lot of these things. I didn't watch stuff on YouTube. These books were being sold right next to brothers where they were preaching over there on downtown Brooklyn. Used to have them Hamites. Used to have all these books. Anyway, so what I like about this is that you're not going to find a lot of the stuff in it now because it's revised. But I'm going to hit you with some of the things they got. First, I'm going to start with page 22. The ignorant Israelites were not sacrificing their children to gods as they thought, but unto devils, right? So Paul tells you that in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 20, right? As history has documented, that greatest objective in pagan worship was the sun, who was symbolized over the world as a heavenly bull. The pagans displayed a cosmic god in their arts as the bull standing on its hind legs with a tail hoofs and horns. With a man's head and arms. Okay? Now, I'm going to just scoot over to the next page and show you who is involved in a lot of this pagan worship. The main features behind the pure demon worship of ancient Babylon, which is 90%, 100% of all religions came from, can be seen today by open worship of Yazidis of Kyrgyzstan, Armenia, and the Caucasus. Who's in the Caucasus Mountains of Minor Asia, Russia? In their pagan worship, they believe it is Malik to us. Who is the devil? That was the co-creator of the world. Their religion today is the worship of both good and evil, or Christ and the Shaitan. That's why they read the Bible as well. They have adopted some heretical elements of Christianity and some priests of Islam. Why? Because these two religions come from ancient Babylon. So it's easy to incorporate these things, right? They regard Jesus as an angel in human form and recognize Muhammad as a prophet with Abraham. Now you're starting to see where all these philosophies come from, right? You're starting to see where the whole Godhead and all that comes from. That's paganism, man, brothers. And practice circumcision and baptism instead of Christ as the creative agent of the Godhead, right? They regard the devil as the creative agent of the supreme God. So they know there's a Most High, and they know that he's on the left and he's on the right. They know that. This is in their own teachings and beliefs, right? So I'm going to show y'all, because I'm going to go back to my real point I want to get to, too, is this heavenly bowl from ancient Babylon. And you're going to see how this trickled down to this exact day.
Right. So this is the heavenly bowl of Shinar, ancient Babylon, what we just read about. This is the heavenly bowl in ancient Egypt. Right. See how they're giving peace offers to this bowl. This is the heavenly bowl, which is known as Moloch. This is what Israelites sacrificed onto devils with. Yes, our people went off and did child sacrifice. It's known as abortion now. This is in ancient Rome and Greece. It was called Jupiter, Marduk, right? This bowl being worshipped right through. Sky God. This is in front of Wall Street. You think that it chose that symbol just because it looks good? No, brothers. This is the ancient religion that has been from the ancient times of Babylon all the way till now. That's what these people are doing. I understand what I'm saying to you? So, without making it too long-winded, that's what I was trying to get into. Brotherhood, brothers keepers, understanding the origin of things, understanding a little bit better on how things work in the beginning of time till now. And I hope you got something out of it. Hope you got edified in some type of way. If you did, hit a comment, hit the like button, help boost the algorithms. See you again next time. Be boy Zacharias. Love y'all. Y'all ride this out. Shalom.